to show you our DC Machine Lab 2. Order code is 46509. So this is the DC Machine Lab trainer kit, and this is the DC shunt motor. This block is for fixed DC supply, and this is for variable DC power supply. You need to give this power supply externally. If you have fixed DC supply and variable DC power supply in your lamp, you can use this, you use those from there. And if you don't, if you don't have this available, you can buy it from Tesco. Now coming to this block, this is for rheostat. This is for 3-point DC starter. There are two ammeters. This is for field current and this is for armature current. This is the DC voltmeter to measure armature voltage. This section here is the connection section. We need to make the connection here to connect with the DC shunt motor. So this is the DC shunt motor. Here the load is applied, and this is the user manual and patch cost. These all are included with this kit. Our first experiment is to study the speed control of separately excited DC shunt motor. So here we need to give fixed DC supply. Here we need to give variable DC power supply. Now there are two ammeter and one DC voltmeter. This is for field current. This is for armature current, and this is for armature voltage. This is the connection. The connection is made according to the figure given in the user manual, and this is the DC shunt motor. So first we will give fixed input DC supply. Around 180 volt. And now we will give the variable DC power supply. You can observe the voltage here. As you can see, as I am increasing voltage, DC shunt motor speed is also increasing. So this is around 180 voltage. Now you can see this is the RPM of the DC shunt motor. Now there is no load on this motor. Now if we increase the load, the load is increasing. You can see as I am increasing the load, the armature current is increasing and the armature voltage is decreasing. You can see the armature current is increasing here, and the voltage is decreasing. Now we will again see the speed of the motor with the help of this tachometer, and we can see the RPM has also decreased. Our next experiment is to observe the characteristics of DC shunt motor. So here I am giving variable DC power supply, and we will see that as I am increasing the voltage, the shunt motor speed will also increase. Here I am giving around 180 voltage. So we will now check the RPM of the motor when no load is applied. This is the RPM of the motor. Now we will increase the load. we can see that as the load is increasing, the armature current is also increasing and the armature voltage is decreasing. Now we will again check the speed of the motor, and we can see that the RPM has also decreased. Our next experiment is to observe, to study self-excited DC shunt motor. So first we will give the variable DC power supply, and we can see that as the voltage is increasing, the speed of the motor is also increasing. So now we will check the RPM of the motor when there is no load applied. Now I am increasing the load. And we can see that as the load is increasing, the armature current is also increasing and the voltage is decreasing. Also, the speed of the motor is also decreasing. We can see that the speed of the motor has also decreased.